Good morning, Shelbyville. My name is Wendell. I'm here to speak up for the babies that are being led to slaughter. You see, the Bible calls us as Christians to come here and speak up for those that are being led to slaughter today. He calls us to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. You see, we're called as Christians to love our neighbors, not to murder our neighbors. You see, this morning, if you are here, if you are on this sidewalk, standing in front of this place, if you are in the building, right now at this moment, if you die, you're going to stand before God as a murderer. You're going to answer for every baby that dies here. Many of you look old enough to be grandmas, mothers. You know that this is a baby. Man, you look old enough to be a grandma. You know that this is a child in the womb. No one has to tell you that. You already know that. We're here to offer you. We're here to share the gospel with you today of Jesus Christ. Before I can share the good news of Christ, I have to share a little bit of bad news today with you. The bad news is this. In Romans 3:23, it says, "For all have sinned and all have fallen short of the glory of God." All have fallen short of the glory of God. You see, you may say this morning that you've never sinned. But you see, the Bible talks about that. It says that if you've ever lied, you've ever stolen, and you've ever looked at a man or a woman with lust, and you've committed adultery with that person in your heart this morning, or whenever you did that, here's what people say they've never done. Have you ever murdered anyone? Have you ever hated anyone? The Bible says if you hate someone, you've committed murder with that person in your heart. That is why you need a Savior today, because you've broken God's law. And you deserve, if we're honest with ourselves, for salvation, we deserve hell. We deserve to die and go to hell and live eternally separated from Christ. You see, it's sad in America when we say that it's okay to murder a child in the womb. But it's not okay to kill a cat or a dog. Why? Why is it not okay to kill a cat or a dog, but it's okay to kill a child in the womb? You know what the Bible says we should do with cats and dogs? It says to eat them, to kill and eat. You may not like that, but it's what it says. It says to kill animals and eat them. You see, that is a baby in the womb. You can say it's a clump of cells. You can say whatever you want. But you see, the Bible says it is a baby at the moment of conception. You know it's a baby. No one has to tell you that it's a baby. You already know that. You see, many of you have been to high school, I'm sure. Many of you have been to high school, you know what science says. Science says that it is a baby. You see, science lines up with the Bible. It is a baby, and you know that. Every one of you standing on this sidewalk, standing up for murdering babies, is going to stand before God. And you're going to answer for every baby that dies here. Your hands are full of blood today. Everything that you touch is full of blood. Everything you own is full of blood. Your hands are full of blood today. I'm begging you guys to walk away from this, to quit volunteering working here. Go somewhere else. Do you not have anything better to do on Friday mornings? Besides, help mornings, Saturday mornings, whatever it is, help murder babies. You laughing at me is not going to harm me, guys. Please repent and turn to Christ. Y'all need Christ today. Y'all need to repent from this wicked act. Because this is evil. This is wicked. How can we say that, like I said, how can we say that it's okay to do this? Yes, the government has said that it's okay to murder a baby in the womb, but you see, the government does not have that authority to murder, to say it's okay to murder a baby in the womb. You see, today, if I could shoot up a school today, what would they do? They'd put me in prison, wouldn't they? I'd go to prison. Who would be protesting for someone not to shoot up a school today? They'd probably be protesters. Wouldn't that be? That person should die, shouldn't it? You may say this morning, mothers, you may say here to you this morning that you're here because you were raped or incest. I want you to know that is a terrible thing that has happened to you. But let me ask you this morning, should we kill the baby for the father's sins? Absolutely not. What did the baby do to deserve to get there? Absolutely nothing. We should kill the father, not the baby. You may say this morning that you have to murder your baby because you had sex outside of marriage. I want you to know that that is a terrible thing. That you should not have sex outside of marriage. That's a sin. But let me ask you, should you kill the baby for your sin? No. You should not. Did the baby do anything to get there? No. It did not. It doesn't deserve to die. It's innocent. You see, the Bible says that if you kill someone, you should die yourself. So yes, mothers and fathers that murder your babies today should die. You should die today. I find it funny how we let so many mothers and fathers stop free from murder. We put murderers in prison today. If someone walked down the road and shot somebody, whatever they do, they put that person in prison for murdering. You see, if I would hit a pregnant woman this morning, they would count it as a double homicide. I would get for killing the baby and the mother. But there again, I thought it was just a clump of cells and it wasn't a baby. Even more, it proves that it's a baby when the courts say it is. You're a mother at this moment. You're a mother at this moment. Do you really think you guys staying here is going to fix these ladies' problems? No, it's not. Let me ask you a question this morning. Do you realize that 60% of women that have abortions, they have suicidal thoughts and depression? What does that lead to? Most often, drug abuse, alcohol abuse. Knowing that somebody may get addicted to drugs because you guys are standing out here, standing up to murder, help murder babies, that's going to be on your conscience to know that. Do you all care? You really do not. As I said, your hands are full of blood this morning. You all need to repent from this wicked act. This is evil. This is wicked. You guys are not guaranteed tomorrow. You guys could die in the next 5 minutes. You need Christ. You need to repent from this wicked act. You see, 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ, truly God, truly man, sent his son to live a perfect life to mean you cannot live. Never sent him word, deed, or thought. He never sent him word, deed, or thought. He never lied. He never stolen. He never looked at a man or a woman with lust. He never murdered anyone. He never hated anyone. He sent his son to die on that cross, and he rose 3 days later. Now he sits at the right hand of the Father, interceding for me and you. And you see, that salvation does not come from man alone. It comes from Christ alone. You cannot be saved by praying a prayer. In America, we believe that we can be saved by praying a magic prayer, or being baptized, or walking an aisle. You see, those things do not save us. We do those things because we are saved. Because we want to obey what God has told us to do. So I'm begging you this morning to think about this, guys. To think about what you are standing up for. Let me ask you today, if this place was involved in raping 15-year-old little girls, would you be standing here this morning? Would any of you be standing here this morning? No, you wouldn't. Nobody in their right mind would stand here if this place was involved in raping 15-year-old little girls. So why are you standing here for baby murder? We're not any better than Hitler. We kill more black babies in places like this than any place in America. You see, this place was set up by a lady that wanted to get rid of black people. That thought that black people were not people, they were animals. Her name's Mary Singer. This is why this place was set up. Do you know what they're going to do to your babies today, mothers? They're going to take your baby this morning, and they're going to take a forceps, and they're going to take your baby, and they're going to crush its skull. And they're going to rip its arms and legs off. And they're going to take a vacuum cleaner type thing and suck your baby out. And they're going to put your baby together on a table like a jigsaw puzzle. And they're going to sell your baby for profit. If you're here for a surgical, that's what they're going to do this morning. If you don't believe me, look up what an abortion is on YouTube. They'll show you step by step. If you're not here for a surgical abortion this morning, you're here for a pill for an abortion. I want you to know that you're going to take that first pill. They're going to send you home and you're going to take the second pill. After you take that second pill, you're going to flush your baby down the toilet. And that's going to go in your water system. And then you're going to be drinking baby cells. And if you're not here for an abortion, they offer other things here. I want you to know, if you're giving money to this place, you're giving money to a place that murders babies. You're saying that it's okay to murder babies. You're giving your money. And you may say this morning, it's not my money. It's my entrance. I want you to know, the entrance you have, that it was given to you by God, the same as everything else you have was given to you by God. You see, everything that you have is given to you by God. The money, the cars that you come in here today, that you came in here to drive into, it was given to you by God. Everything that you have was given to you by God. There's not one thing that you don't have that wasn't given to you by God. The breath that you're taking at this moment, you don't deserve. Nobody deserves the breath that we take. We all deserve this morning to die and go to hell. But by God's grace, you can have God's grace and forgiveness today. You can have salvation today. And today, the evidence that you have repented and turned away from your sin is that God will take your heart of stone and He will give you a heart of flesh. You see, you're no longer want to come to places like this and volunteer. You no longer want to lie. You no longer want to steal. You no longer want to look at a man or a woman with lust. You see, He will take your heart of stone and He will give you a heart of flesh. You no longer want to do these things. Not saying you'll never sin, because still, as a Christian, I still sin. But the difference in me and you this morning is when I sin, I am broken for that sin. I repent. I recognize my sin and I turn away. I repent. And I don't live in unrepentant sin. You see, this is not going to help the mothers by standing here this morning. It's not going to help them. You're not helping them. They're mothers. No matter if they murder their baby, they're always going to be a mother. The question this morning is, are they going to be a mother of a living child or a dead child? My whole poem is a living child today, not a dead child. Ma'am, let us help you. Does Black Lives Matter? If Black Lives Matter, ma'am, what about the black baby that is in your room this morning? That is a black baby. That is your child. That is made in the image of God. Please have mercy on it. Don't murder it this morning.
You're murdering children, sir.
Have mercy on it. As God has had mercy on you this morning, He has. You see, God has given you everything, as I said. He's given you everything you have. That's God's mercy and grace to you this morning.
Perfectly happy.
Are you okay with the
breath that you take is given to you by God. Each one of you wearing masks this morning. You guys are wearing masks this morning because you value your own lives, but you do not value the children's lives that you're leading to help murder. Why do you value your own lives but not a child's life? Why are you so scared to die? That mask is not going to save you. Even if you wear a mask, you need Christ. That's the only one that can save you. You can wear the mask all you want, and it's not going to save you, ma'am. Let us help you. Let us talk with you, please. Have mercy on your child. So please, I'm pleading with you guys this morning to have mercy, to not go through with this, to murder your children, not to stand here anymore, to walk away from this place. Guys, I'm going to give you the gospel one more time. The gospel is simply this. You see, in Romans 3:23, it says, "For all have sinned and all have fallen short of the glory of God." It says in Romans 6:23, "For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord and our Savior." You see, you have sinned. You're breaking God's law. And at this moment, you deserve hell. So you need Christ. Jesus Christ sent his son to live a perfect life, to mean you can now live. Never sinning word to your thought. Never lying, never stealing, never looking at another person with lust, never hating his neighbor. He loved his neighbor. He sent his son down that cross. He was beaten, he was whipped, he was spit on. When he died on that cross, he rose 3 days later, and I sit at the right hand of the Father interceding for me and you this morning. And that's why you need Christ, because he sent his son this morning. Because you have sinned. I would ask you this morning to repent and believe the gospel. You see, God commands you this morning to repent and believe the gospel. To repent and turn to him before it's too late. Because none of you are guaranteed tomorrow. None of you are guaranteed 5 minutes from now. You can stand before God at any moment. You don't know how long you have. What are you going to say to God when you stand before him? That I was helping women. You're not helping anybody. But please, repent and believe the gospel. There again, the evidence today that you are saved is that you will walk away, that you repent, and God will take your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. And you no longer want to come here. You no longer want to be in a place like this. So I would beg you this morning to have mercy, to not stand for the, not to stand for murder. Men do not stand up for murder. Men stand up and protect women and children as they are called to do. Cowards stand up for the for murder. That's what cowards do. So you are a coward today because you're standing up for murder. You're not a man, neither are you. Men do not stand here and help murder babies. Men stand up for women and children. They protect them. You see, that God has called you to do that today, to protect women and children. And instead, you're being a coward. You're not being a man. You're not doing what God has called you to do as a man. So please repent from that. Turn away from this wicked, wicked act. Thank you, guys.
That was rough. That was rough. I had a rough day. I'm stumbling a little bit. I'm going to go a little better now. I don't know what I do, but I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it better now.
Both of us do. Absolutely.